All right, guys, we are at a no heat kind of a deal. Heat pump, RHEEM. Running the system.
Yeah.
There's your badge of honor right there. Anyway, RHEEM. Calling for heat. Got airflow upstairs. Got heat strips upstairs. Condenser's not running. We do have 240 volts. I don't have my tripod, so I don't know what kind of video angle I'm going to be able to get here. So maybe that gets enough to kind of get a general idea of what I'm doing. But anyway, so we have no call. Well, yeah, we got 24 volts, so we do have a call on Y. So our LED light on this, we got a 1 and a 2, and you'll see that number 2 is out. Number 1 is giving us a constant flash right there. So let's look up that fault code real quick and see what we have. Oh, where is it listed at on this thing? So, do we have a chart on this that tells you what your faults are? Doom, doom, doom. Let me get a little closer. I don't have my damn glasses on. So, this little... Alright, so I had to get my little eyeglasses out. So, RHEEM puts their little flash code fault list on the board itself. So, we've got the DS1 flashing. DS2 is out. So... flashing off, high pressure lockout. So, one is flashing, confirm that. So number 1 is flashing constantly. Number 2 is out. According to this, LED 1, constant flash. LED 2 is off. We are on a high pressure lockout. So, if they were running it in the heating mode, a high pressure switch lockout would typically occur with an extremely dirty filter, because it's a heat pump. You lose airflow on your blower in heating, your head pressure goes up. You lose your outdoor fan in cooling, your head pressure goes up. So I don't know if they were running this in heating or cooling. I'm not sure. But we are going to hook some gauges up to it real quick and confirm whether or not we actually have any pressure in the system. We should, in theory, because it's a high pressure lockout, not a low pressure lockout. But I'm gonna go ahead and set the gauges on there and see what our standing pressure looks like. All right, so we got the gauges hooked up. Our standing pressure on this thing is 192. Which is probably about right for these temperatures, 410A stand system. So to reset this board, you just basically short the test pins on it. I'm not gonna do that quite yet. I don't have my tripod. Like I said, I think I may have left that in somebody's attic or something. I don't know. I've got another one supposed to be delivered from Amazon. Makes it a little easier. I try to have both hands available when I'm working, and the headband I wear is at the house, so it is what it is. So let's short the test pins on this thing and see what happens, find out why it's tripping high pressure. Alright, so we've got the fan. Now let's see what our pressures are going to do on this thing. I'm wondering if it's overcharged because I have airflow. The blower's running upstairs, at least it was when I came out, because I turned the thermostat on first, cycled everything on, and they said an evaporator coil was replaced in this thing not maybe about like 2 months ago. I think another company did it, and these RHEEMs typically don't run on on the volume of charge that other systems run at. So I'm wondering if they just didn't pay any attention to what they were doing, and maybe they overcharged it and it's tripping head pressure in heat mode because the fan's running out here. And we're gonna let that run a little while and see what happens. But the fan is running, so if they were running the air conditioning and the fan was running, obviously that would be a key indicator of a high pressure switch, refrigerant pressure switch trip in cooling mode. Outdoor fan not running, not pulling the heat out of the condenser like it should. With this unit in heat mode, I don't know. Overcharge. The filters were clean. I checked those when I was up there. And it is a ream. It could just have a bad pressure switch in it that wants to trip from time to time. But we're going to watch this thing. We'll see what it does. And kind of let it stabilize out a little bit. But right now for heat mode, which is what it's in, and it is 70 degrees outside, probably 68 right here in this shade. Plus we got some clouds moving in. Some rain's coming here in a little bit. But 130 over 337 on a heat pump, 70 degrees outside. I mean, obviously the air coming through this condenser is a lot warmer than regular heat operation. You're gonna run those pressures up a little high in this situation. It's absorbing a lot more heat. If I'm not mistaken, most heat pumps, the baseline operation temperature is around 45, 47 degrees outside. So basically at 45, 47 degree outdoor temperature, a 3-ton heat pump is gonna give you 3 tons of heating, basically, 36,000 BTUs. Every 10 degree drop in temperature when you're running a heat pump, you know, you're gonna lose about 10, 15% of your capacity for heating. The cooler the air gets outside, that's why you have heat strips in it for backup. But every 10 degree rise in outdoor temperature above that baseline, you're pulling in a lot more heat and you can run the pressures up on it pretty good. So I'm really not thinking overcharge anymore at this point because those pressures are hanging in there pretty tight. So I'm gonna watch in a few minutes and see what we come up with. So it continued to run pretty fine. Pressures are maintaining, so I'm gonna start seeing what might have caused a switch to trip. Like I said, it could be a bad switch in itself. It's working right now. So our capacitor, let's switch that. Microfarads. So I really don't like doing this with one hand. We're trying to record, and so like I said, my new tripod will be here either today or tomorrow. But anyway, so you can see we've got 5. So the fan capacitor is fine for the outdoor unit. So the motor is not hot. Not any oil that I can see anywhere. And when you shut it down, it just keeps spinning and spinning and spinning very freely. So I'm not seeing any issue with it trying to seize up or lock up. Like I said, I did run a temperature probe on the frame of the motor, and the motor temperature's fine. It's not getting hot. So I think we're fine with this. Yeah, it's not even warm. So I don't think there's a problem with the motor. So and we've had a lot of warm weather the last couple of weeks. Hasn't really been, I mean, now the last 3 nights it's been down close to freezing at night. They did have it set for heat upstairs. They had it set on 61, which is odd. Some people do stuff like that. But anyway, I cranked it up to about 74, and it's been running a little while. I mean, the head pressure's finally stabilized out at around like 128, 129, 350, 348, 345. So, flip side would be, do we have a problem with the blower upstairs? I don't know if it's got an X13 in it or not. We'll find out in just a minute when we get up there. If it's got a capacitor, a split capacitor motor, we'll test the capacitor on it and inspect that motor, see what condition it's in. Well, let's head up into the attic. What's up, Riley? What's up, buddy? Yeah. What's up, fella? What's going on? Hey there. Alright, so now I got this thing running in cooling. I just figured while I was already out here and hooked up, I might as well go ahead and run it in cooling. Check the pressures in cooling before I go up there and check that blower. Try to just make kind of one trip. Try to work efficient. Go ahead and deal with everything I got to deal with outside, then I'll head upstairs and check that. Anyway, here's our pressures right there. So it's looking good in cooling, so not quite sure why it would have been tripped. I'm gonna have to go talk to the homeowner and find out if anybody else has been here, done anything in the last few days. They usually don't, a lot of them don't volunteer. You gotta investigate and ask some questions. But we've been running air conditioning around here pretty much the last couple of weeks. Pollen's been falling. We had an 80 degree day, 70s. Last few nights we did have some 30s, which would have, you know, and if they just left it off, it is an upstairs unit and downstairs heat rising, maybe, you know, they don't keep it set too high. It was on 61 when I got here. He said they keep it around 66 upstairs. And I can't see that an upstairs system in this climate, you know, is going to run very often in heat, because the downstairs system is going to run more. Obviously, your heat loss is from the downstairs up. So the downstairs is running. It's heating down there, feeding heat upstairs. The upstairs might, in milder weather, cycle on a few times. So if it was in heat mode, it would have been an outdoor fan situation more than likely. Thinking cooling. I get into mixed in the middle of the season. You start doing heating and cooling calls, you start getting mixed up with what you're thinking. But so if it was running in heating, it would have been a blower issue. That blower's been running constantly now for probably 35, 40 minutes. I'm gonna go up there and check it. If it's done in cooling, you know, it's gonna freeze up if the blower shuts off upstairs. It's gonna trip high head pressure. It's gonna be an airflow issue outside that would cause that. And I'm not seeing any indicators of that. This thing's running just fine. But I'm gonna ask a few questions when I go in there. Has anybody else been here the last couple of days? Maybe they, you know, weren't happy and had us come out or something. I don't know. But I'll get back to you on that. Let's head up in the attic and check that blower. Had to run out and get my drill. Yeah, he's got that music going pretty good. He's got some kind of a music studio in his bonus area down there. A lot of guitars, keyboards, music stands, microphones, computers and stuff set up. So I don't know if he does, some kind of, maybe some production type work along those lines. I don't know. Pretty cool setup in there, though. Alrighty, so see what kind of motor we've got back here, because it's running strong. Not seeing a problem with it. And it's spinning free till it stops. And damn it, X13. Well, good thing is no capacitor to check. Yeah, I can do. I pull those plugs out, but I still pull the disconnect before I stick my hand back in there. So anyway, make sure everything's plugged in nice and tight, and nothing's loose. it's running, so obviously I'm getting a high voltage and a call. So, I mean, this unit's not very old. I feel like I'm missing something from the information he was giving me. So I'm gonna talk to him before I leave and see if I can dig a little more out of him. I just feel like there's something more that I'm not hearing. So there's the model number. Where's the damn serial number on this? There's another sticker right over here. The big one, of course. Some jackass came up here and ran tape around this thing. There's our serial number. So 2019. So this unit's only 4 years old. 3 to 4. So anyway, I don't understand why it was out on high head pressure. It was running it. Something, I don't know. I'll talk to this guy and there'll be an additional couple of minutes to this video if my investigation leads to some unknown information that may have saved me some time here. Black crows, gentlemen, black crows. All right, I finished up talking with the homeowner. It ended up being a 45-minute conversation because, well, we got sidetracked in his music room with his guitars and his pictures and autographs, and we started talking about all the concerts that we've been to and him from the 70s, the Marshall Tucker Band and the Eagles, and all the way up to Van Halen and Iron Maiden and Judas Priest and Motley Crue and Kiss and Def Leppard, REO Speedwagon, Boston, Journey, all the concerts we've been to, not together, but we ended up having a lot of stuff in common when it came to that, so that drug out a little bit. Then we got talking about dogs, both dog lovers. I've got a boxer pit mix at home and a retriever, and he's got a full-blooded plot hound, which is a beautiful dog. That dog is a smart dog as well. But anyway, got the story. There's always the house from time to time. The homeowner's got a buddy that does heating and air. Or they know somebody that knows somebody. Or they got a friend. A couple days ago, he was there doing some checking for him. Trying to save money on a kind of a half-ass maintenance, I guess. Anyway, got up in the attic. Last place he went, and I guarantee you that guy took the door off that air handler, which I don't know how, because it's got the plug in the front of the door that you have to take out to get the door off, which really shuts everything down, unless he put it back in and turned everything on so he can get his amp draws. Maybe he did that if he was checking. There's no capacitor in there. Maybe he did something, was running it, the door off or something, and it went out on high air pressure. But the guy said he hadn't had a single issue until that day. So it worked fine. It's only 3 years old, 4 years old. So maybe that's what it was. The damn door was off while it was running. And now he's running it in heat. And then head pressure tripped. I don't know. I checked that thing, and it does have an X13 motor in it. That's the only outlier, and we know what the reliability of those are. So anyway, I ran it in heating, ran it in cooling, and none of the pressures are getting anywhere close to what would trip on a high pressure switch in an outdoor unit. So we'll see. See if it happens again, he'll call back. I said, just keep an eye on it and see what happens. And call us back. We're only 5 miles from his house to the shop. So Anyway, guys, thanks for watching. Down there in the corner, the subscribe button. If you want to push that and subscribe, I'd appreciate it. Appreciate everybody that has. And we'll see you on the next one. You guys have a good weekend. And we'll get back at it on Monday.